The Intech ODE Mark II is a one-universe bidirectional DMX Ethernet converter. It comes in two variants: standard with a DC input, with power supply included in the box. As of 2020, this is 7.5 volt to 24 volt DC. Before that, we just shipped with 7.5 volt. And we also have the PoE variant. Now this uses 48 volt IEEE 802.3AF PoE. This means it performs a handshake when it connects to the switch. Not one of the types that just receives any random voltage and tries to power on. This means it's a lot more reliable and makes connectivity a lot more convenient for larger installations. Now let's look at the hardware. On one end we've got the TEM100 Ethernet connector. This is an Ethercon. We've got the status LEDs. At the top we're going status, direction, link and activity. We've also got the DC input. On the other end we've got our two DMX connectors. These are 5-pin. As I said before, this is a one universe node, so this can be used to chain DMX through when receiving DMX, or you just plug in a single connector when you're outputting. Plug the ODE Mark II into your network infrastructure with a network cable. Once connected, add power from the DC power supply. The ODE Mark II will boot up, and once ready, it'll flash a status LED with a slow blink. For the PoE variant, simply plug it into a PoE network switch and wait for it to boot up. Here I'm using a cable with an Ethercon. After the ODE Mark II has been plugged in, the next step is to navigate to its web interface to configure it. I'm using a PC, so I'm going to use Entech's NMU software to do discovery and then go onto its web page. If you don't have access to the NMU software, you can look at the IP address printed on the box, or if you're on a DHCP network, you can do an IP scan. Videos of how to do this, along with changing your computer's IP address, can be found elsewhere on our channel. Once the NMU window opens, I'm going to press Discovery. This is going to discover all Entech devices on the network. So here we are. I'm going to select this and press Configure. This will open the web page inside my web browser. So initially we can see the home page. This has got all of the device information, including its IP address, netmask, and network gateway. Right now we can see the defaults are set to ArtNet as an output on Universe 0, with its send rate at max, which is around 44 frames a second, and merging has been disabled. Send 2 isn't filled out as we're receiving ArtNet. By navigating to the settings page, we can define the node name, if we want to enable or disable DHCP, set a static IP address, or identify it to control 4. The DMX port settings allow for output, input, or we can disable it if the installation isn't in use. The protocol can be set to ArtNet, ESP, or streaming ACN. To use ArtRDM, make sure to tick the box on the right-hand side of the dropdown. If you don't have any RDM fixtures, leave this unticked. Universe settings are everything that would be expected. We can set the net or subnet for ArtNet, or just straightforward universe for streaming ACN. The refresh rate can be defined using the dropdown. Merging can be performed between two universes of the same protocol. HTTP allows the highest values to be output from the DMX port, whereas LTP allows the latest values to be output from the DMX port. This is useful in scenarios where you may have two different control consoles in a venue and you want to move between each. Finally, you can save settings, reset to factory defaults, or restart your ODE Mark II. The network stats page allows you to see previous IP addresses that you've been sending to. Right now this is empty, as we've just booted up the device. Finally, we can update firmware. When we press this button, the ODE Mark II reboots into its update mode. This allows us to see the current system information, network settings, and then allows you to choose a file and upload it. After pressing update firmware, it'll usually take around 30 seconds to a minute to apply fully, and after this we'll reboot. If you're using a DHCP network, it's worth doing a rescan using the NMU software or your IP scanner, as the IP address may have changed and you wouldn't be able to access the web interface. Thanks for watching this overview. Catch you in the next video.